हेलो गाइस, वेलकम टू माय चैनल। प्रेस द सब्सक्राइब बटन लाइक दिस एंड देन यू हैव टू टैप द बेल आइकन एडजेसेंट टू द सब्सक्राइब बटन लाइक दिस एंड देन यू विल गेट द नोटिफिकेशन फ्रॉम माय चैनल।
हेलो गाइस, वेलकम टू माय चैनल। इन दिस वीडियो आई विल एक्सप्लेनिंग यू द गियर ट्रेन्स। इन माय प्रीवियस वीडियो आई एक्सप्लेन द क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ द गियर्स। And if you have not watched my previous video, you can click on the top right corner I appearing on your screen right now. Now let's start with the gear trains. Now gear trains, it means the combination of the gears. That means when we use more than two gears, then that is known as gear trains. On a single shaft, we mount different gears. It can be two or more than two. And in the other shaft, we also mount the same amount of gears, so they will interact with each other. So in general, you remember that when more than two gears are used, it is known as gear train. Now why we require gear train? When the center to center distance is very large, then we require, and when we require the very high or very low velocity ratios, then we require the gear train or combination of the gears. Now any gear train, it can be a combination of three types of gears, that is the main driver gear, the main driven and the intermediate gears. That is one gear, it is the main driver gear, that is we supply the power of the output power to that gear, that is the main driver gear, and the intermediate gears that transfer the power from the main driver gear to the main driven gear, that are known as the intermediate gears. And finally, the power when it reaches to the last gear, that is known as the main driven gear. Now there are two terms, one is the speed ratio and one is the train value. Now speed ratio, it is the ratio of the angular velocity of the main driver upon main driven, that is omega. Omega is the angular velocity of the main driver gear upon the main driven gear, that is the speed ratio. And train value, it is 1 upon speed ratio, so it will be omega main driven upon omega main driver. Now let's move on to types of gear trains. First is the simple gear train, and simple gear train, that is it has the main driver. Suppose this is the main driver gear, so we supply omega to this gear. This main driver gear, it transfers the power to the intermediate gears. Now 2 and 3 here, they are the intermediate gears, and finally the power is transferred to this 4, that is the main driven gear. So gear number 1, it is main driver gear, gear number 2 and 3 are intermediate gears, and gear number 4 is main driven gear. Now here you can see that when gear 1 is rotated clockwise, then the 2, it will rotate anticlockwise. And when 2, it will rotate anticlockwise, so gear 3 will rotate clockwise, and hence gear 4 will rotate anticlockwise. So you remember that adjacent pairs, they rotate in opposite direction. And suppose if omega of 1 was in this direction, that means anticlockwise. Had it been anticlockwise, so 2 would be clockwise, and hence 3 would be anticlockwise and 4 would be clockwise, likewise. Also remember that the intermediate gears, they are known as idlers, idler gears. Now we have some relations. The relations are omega 1 upon omega 2 is equal to T2 upon T1, that is the number of teeth on gear 2 upon number of teeth on gear 1. And for 2-3 pair, we have omega 2 upon omega 3 is equal to T3 upon T2, and omega 3 upon omega 4 is equal to T4 upon T3. Because power transferred is same, and what we know that power, we have the relations that omega, it is inversely proportional to the number of teeth. So by that we get this relation, omega 1 upon omega 2 equal to T2 upon T1, omega 2 upon omega 3 is equal to T3 upon T2, omega 3 upon omega 4 equal to T4 upon T3. Now, when we multiply these three equations, so we can see that omega 1 upon omega 2 into omega 2 upon omega 3 into omega 3 upon omega 4. So these will get cancelled, and what is left is omega 1 upon omega 4 is equal to T4 upon T1. Now omega 1 upon omega 4 is equal to T4 upon T1 is equal to speed ratio. Next comes the compound gear train. Compound gear train. In this gear train, we have more than one gears on a particular shaft or on a particular intermediate shaft. We have more than one gear. Now suppose gear number 1, this is the main driver gear. Gear number 6, this is the main driven gear. And on the intermediate shafts, we have two gears each. On this shaft, we have gear number 2 and 3. And on this shaft, we have gear number 4 and 5. And the main driven gear, it drives gear number 2. And when this gear 2 rotates, this on the same shaft, gear number 3 is mounted. So it also rotates. And we have coupled this gear number 3 with gear number 4. And when this shaft rotates, because of rotation of gear number 4, so gear number 5 also rotates because it is mounted on the same shaft. And due to gear number 5, it is in contact with gear number 6. So finally, gear number 6 rotates. So we have pair 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5, 6. We have three pairs, that these three pairs, they mate each other. And when applying the same concept, omega 1 upon omega 2 equal to T2 upon T1, and 3 upon 4 equal to T4 upon T3, 5 upon 6 equal to T6 upon T5, we multiply all these, we get omega 1 upon omega 6 is equal to T6 upon T1. Now here, the gear, they will not get cancelled. Sorry, omega 1 upon omega 6 will be T2 upon T1 into T4 upon T3 into T6 upon T5. So we can see that even number gears, they come on the numerator, and odd numbers, they come on the denominator. Or we can say that the driven gears, they come, the teeth of the driven gears, they come on the numerator, and teeth of the driver, they come on the denominator. Because we know that T1, it is number of teeth on the gear number 1, and gear number 1 is the driver gear. Similarly, gear number 3 is driver gear. Similarly, 5 number gear, it is driver gear. And we know that T2, it is driven by T1, T4, it is driven by T3, T6, it is driven by T5, or gear number 5. So we write the corresponding teeth numbers of these gears, that is T2, T4, T6 of the driven gears, gear number 2, gear number 4 and gear number 6, and T1, T3, T5 correspond to the teeth of the driver gears 1, 3 and 5. Next comes the reverted gear train. Now, reverted gear train is that compound gear train which connects two coaxial shafts. Coaxial means on the, that is the axis of the main driven and the main driver, they are same. That is the axis or the shaft of the main driver gear and the main driven gear, they lie on the same axis. So that is known as reverted gear train. So gear number 1, it rotates gear number 2, and because of rotation of gear number 2, this shaft rotates, and gear 3 is mounted on this shaft, so gear number 3 rotates, and finally gear number 4 rotates, and it transfers its power to main driven shaft. So from main driver to main driven, and 2 and 3 it is known as compound gear. So again we apply the same formula. So omega 1 upon omega 4 equal to speed ratio equal to T2 into T4 upon T1 into T3. T2 it is driven, T4 it is driven, and T1 it is driver, T3 it is driver. Corresponding to those we write the teeth. And a general concept is there, that is R1 plus R2 equal to R3 plus R4. Now how this is written, you see the diagram here. Now R3 means this distance, R4 means this distance, R1 means this distance, and R2 means up from here to here. So we can see that because this plus this equal to this plus this, and this distance it is said to be R1 because R is the radius of this gear, R1. Similarly R2, R4 and R3. So what we can write, R4 plus R3 is equal to R1 plus R2. And now we substitute the values of radius of the gears as M into T1 by 2. Because what is M? M is the module of the gear. Here when we consider the gear module to be same, then M will get cancelled from all the sides. Otherwise, the M will be different for different gears. So we write M into T1 upon 2 plus M into T2 upon 2 equal to M dash T3 upon 2 plus M dash T4 upon 2. 2 gets cancelled. M T1 plus T2 equal to M dash T3 plus T4. Had the modules be same, so M dash and M will be equal, so they would get cancelled. That is, if all the gears have same module, and T1 plus T2 equal to T3 plus T4. And so this was the basic concept. I hope you found the video helpful. In the next video I'll be taking some numericals on gear train. And if you found the video helpful, please press the like button, please share my video, and please check the description once, and do subscribe my channel if you have already not subscribed. In the next video I'll be taking the numericals on the gear train. Stay tuned, take care, bye bye.